In your view, are his criticisms of the National Executive Committee and the party structure the right ones?
They are absolutely right, and they are absolutely valid. And the one aspect that Henry and I both share is that during our own leadership campaigns, we campaigned on platforms such as an update of the Constitution to change the party infrastructure, principally the NEC composition, its structure and its remit, to introduce new elements such as the management body, to have a really good financial overview and scrutiny, and to look at appointing the right people into the right places within the party structure, be it spokespersons or individuals holding particular areas. Now, I stood down after my short period because everything I campaigned for, I was blocked in actually completing, undertaking and introducing. And I decided that my personal credibility would not stand for that. Where I give Henry some real credit here, he's picked up exactly what the issues are. Yes, it's taking him time to actually implement the changes, but I can tell you from my experience, it's not something you can do overnight. And if he is able to go to the party membership in a few weeks' time via an EGM and outline, and I think he would do it honestly and openly, the problems he's come up against, what he believes the resolutions are, then I think it's worthy that the membership has the opportunity to listen to what he's got to say. And I think they might well buy into what he's actually got to promote.
So, Diane, do you support Henry as leader?
Yes, I do. He's shown, I believe, in the few months that he's been around, that he's prepared to focus on the job. He's gone about it quietly. He's gone about it diligently. But I believe he's got results in the train which he's prepared to unveil and show. But if the party membership allows the opposition to derail, to destabilise him, much as they've done with me, with Paul Nuttall, with a whole host of other people, then all they will deliver is the opposition's objective of killing UKIP and potentially killing Brexit as well. You know, you don't run a modern political party with a constitution that's effectively two decades old. You don't run it with an NEC formulated in the way it is, composed in the way it is. You know, with the UKIP, and I'm no longer a member, I'm merely an observer, I'm watching with huge sadness what's going on. But, you know, if I compare it with the Labour Party's NEC, which is now being taken over by Momentum, all that will happen if Henry is unable to change the NEC is that you will see the same old stuff going on and ever on into the future. Yeah. And quite frankly, UKIP will then die.
Diane James, thank you very much indeed. Well, that was Diane James.